What's up, guys? Colin from DecoNetwork. Hybrid screen printing equipment. What do you know about it? Well, we recently caught up with Michael Zombra of INO at the recent Long Beach Impressions Expo and asked him anything and everything about this equipment and if it could be beneficial for your business. So let's get into the video.
And what you'll do is, you can take the screen now out without taking the squeegee and scraper off.
Wow.
Right? So now you can see your screen, clean it, or just use a different one, slide it back in to the position, lock it, press screen centering.
Anybody can operate this?
Basically, yes. And from this position, you will just turn automatic mode on, press start button, and you can start printing from this position. I can show you later on how much it goes down, but 5,000 sheets at least.
What kind of clientele is most common in purchasing these types of machines?
Using our machines, mostly heat transfers. We do have companies printing labels, water slides. We do have some.
I was wondering about that too. Yeah. Other than heat, are there other applications?
Yes, sir. And we also have them in automotive industry. We have them in printable electronics industry. Those machines also have the cleaning unit. So just before every sheet gets to be printed, there's a special cleaning unit that cleans every sheet. So it's totally clean, no dust on it, especially for electronics or soft keyboards.
So not chips, but semiconductors?
Yes, okay, or flexible electronics, stuff like that, yeah.
Pressure-sensitive vinyl?
Yeah.
Yep.
How much will one of these machines run you, cost-wise?
So the setup, as you're looking here, plus the dryer, would be around $360,000. That includes training, installation, shipping costs are not included in the price, and of course, import taxes.
INO Italian?
INO is Slovenian.
Slovenian?
Yeah, that's okay. Just west of Italy.
Okay.
Yeah. And from there on, there's a powdering unit.
Yes,
so how it works is,
well, they'll just do their spot color work.
Right now it's in transport mode only, so no powdering. So this is where you add your powder and it will drop down here onto your sheets. The residual of powder drops into that sink and comes back on this side. From there on, there are two vacuums. You can see the bar, the grill underneath the belt, and there's this top vacuum. So we basically have two vacuums. One is on the bottom of the sheets holding the sheet down, and the upper one is cleaning the sheets. And also, exactly, and also all that powder from the top that gets cleaned will return on the right side of the machine. So all the powder is recirculating, and all this air extracting from the motors is being filtered by that filter cabinet. On the bottom of that filter, if there's any powder coming there, there's a jar and all this powder will collect there, and you can reuse that one too. Just put it back in and you're off you go. So from here on, you would have a dryer. Our dryers are electric powered. There's an option to have higher heaters on too. And in the front of it, you can also have a UV unit if you're using UV inks.
Oh, wow.
Yes, sir.
UV
is. Yes, sir. And all the dryers are divided by sections of 2 meters. So you can really build your own configuration according to what inks you're using, what's your drying time, average drying time. In the end, you have a catcher or stacker with automatic, basically not automatic, you just punch in the sheet size and it will adopt automatically. And all the settings that you do on the dryer, so each section in the dryer can be individually set to the different temperatures. So you can have gradual heating of your, or the drying of your ink, especially for water-based, so you don't skin it up and have trapped.
Sometimes you want to gel it, sometimes you want to cure it.
Exactly.
What about the actual printing of the full color transfer? That's a totally different machine.
No.
So where are we printing the full color CMYK?
So what you would do is you would start, of course, with first, second, third, fourth color, and you would use bottom sensors, as I showed you before, to do the registration. Yeah, I don't have a sheet here.
So are you
on the edge?
you would hybrid print. Like
this is a hybrid print, yeah. But then you would take blank polyester sheets or paper sheets,
yep.
Load them in, start with first color, second, third, fourth, fifth, whatever. Okay. But of course you have to have different screen for every other color because it's screen printing, right? So yep. You have to print one color at a time.
Yep.
Can you talk about how easy it is to use a machine like this?
Yes.
Someone buys this, they get it shipped to their house, how quick can they expect to immediately start printing?
So by the time the machine gets into the house, it's being installed normally the same day. If I'm there in the morning, in the evening you're up and running. If all goes by the plan, electric connections, air connections, we're up and running in the evening.
And you're in the States?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I do customer support. I do the installations, training of the operators, and then later on, of course, customer support, service visits. Be on the phone with you guys in case any problems.
How nice is it to be back at a trade show like this and be able to show off your equipment?
It is nice. Due to Corona situation, all the shows that's been canceled, it is nice to be back, yeah, and seeing all the people.
What's been the reception like of people walking up and looking at the machine? Are they really impressed with it?
Of course, you have different audience, right? So yeah. There are people just wondering because there's something moving, something's making sound noise, so they kind of, it attracts people. And yeah, you have experienced screen printers or screen printers that know what they're looking at. And yeah, so you get different feedbacks, different questions, but we are happy to answer even the person who sees the first time the screen printing equipment, what it actually does and how it works.
I love transfers. They're so much easier to take someone at the end, heat press this instead of you've got to learn how to screen print.
Yeah, I mean, and that's our goal. So you don't have to have an experienced screen printer to be able to operate this machine. Because as I said before, what you can all set on this line, you can save it as a machine recipe. That means all the settings punched in the PLC can be saved as a machine recipe. So the operator will just click on your job number, sorry, name, I don't know, backing white, water based, click on it, press start, and that recipe will send all the settings to all the line, to all the machines, and it will adopt to it. And he's ready to go. So he doesn't have to worry about the speed, drying time, drying temperatures, armor sensors, up or down, whatever. Just click on a recipe and off he goes.
You've eliminated a lot of variables that take the art out of screen printing.
Exactly.
You've also reduced a lot of labor. While yes. The equipment might be expensive, yeah. It's actually saving a lot of money in the stakes and everything else.
Well, by our calculations, operating this line like 8 hours a day, it would pay off within a year. And then everything else is just a
problem. Transfers are only getting more and more popular. I mean, they've always been popular. I've always been pro transfers. And I do bet that you do get a lot of people. What about DTF? It's a totally different game. Direct-to-film is one-off based. This is more bulk, hybrid.
Yeah, so DTF covers, by my opinion, different areas. It's just a different type of system. So DTF is perfect if you want to do one t-shirt or 10 t-shirts, right? You probably won't do one screen for 10 t-shirts because cost-wise, it just doesn't go through. But I think sampling small amounts or individual t-shirts or garments, yes, DTF is a perfect solution for that. And then from there on, we have customers printing 10 sheets per order, they were just fine. And from there up to 500-600 sheets per order, I see INO machine as best solution. And from there on, you can get a cylinder press. Because again, cylinder, of course, it's much faster with printing, but it has a bit longer setup time, which...
But you've moved the bottleneck, essentially.
I'm sorry?
You've kind of moved the bottleneck.
Yes, sir.
Where it slows down.
Caught that space in between. Yeah.
One person can run this whole in.
Normally, yes, without any problems. If you have a runner that brings ink, screens, and stuff like that, one person is more than enough to run a machine like that.
Absolutely.
And the whole line communicates to itself, so you would have an error on the stacker. So if I open the doors here, the whole line stops. When you close the doors, reset the air, press start, the whole line starts again, printing again. So you don't have to run all the way there to press start button. It does it automatically.
Are there any other manufacturers who really do this? Is there a couple, like Sakurai you mentioned?
Sakurai is a cylinder press manufacturer, very good machines.
Like Heidelberg?
I never met. Atma has solutions, Familiar Solutions.
Okay.
Yeah. A few manufacturers of flatbread screen printing machines, equipment. So normal, it depends on what kind of ink you're using. So if you're using plastisol, which is a bit thicker ink, the squeegee probably needs to pull a bit slower. You're looking at, with a small machine, you're looking at around 500, 550 sheets per hour. But if you can do it full speed, if that, if ink allows you to do it, you're looking at 750, maybe 800 prints. That really depends also on the sheet size. Yes, sir.
That's the big thing. I don't care how many come out, how many are perfect.
Yes. Yeah, we're looking into it, so that's the registration effort.
Screen printing one color transfers is like printing money. Multicolor, twice as hard.
Yeah, of course. If you can charge it, if you can charge your customer, I don't see why, but the thing is, yeah, it's hard to sell it.
And the hand is very great with that water-based, I know.
Yeah.
It's all about that PET film, being able to see the clear print. It's real easy to apply.
Yeah. This is also super stretchable. It's right, it's not, this one is not the right garment, I'm sorry. This is workwear. This is workwear. Where is that sample? Because the garment is not elastic. Is it this one? Well, this one is one of the, and you can't really break it. It has memory, which is good, so it comes back. Nevertheless, how much you stretch it, or even this one. Stretch and look how it comes back.
Any temperature when you back it with the right ink.
Yes, sir. So the applying temperature always goes by the adhesive.
Yeah.
What kind of adhesive you apply it on? Either powder or principal adhesive.
And I can tell you're curing this. You're not when it's gelled. Does it have a little bit of the powder kind of feel the powder a little bit?
This is principal adhesive. That's why the feel is it feels so smooth.
Yep.
With powder, it's a bit more rough. But yeah, when it melts, you shouldn't be able to feel any like particles of powder on it. It really gets gelled.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for coming by.
Thanks.
Thank you.